hard. The days just seem so dark, and the moon and the stars are nothing without you. Your touch, your skin, where do I begin? No words can explain the way I'm missing you. Deny this emptiness, this hole that I'm
like this. Well, in that case, you did an amazing job of making sure it didn't beat you, and that's the important thing. At the end of the day, you know, Joey mentioned, you know, beforehand or just after, and I don't know, he mentioned it that, you know, you have to carry on, and that was a prime example of that. And if anything, I think that made you sound a lot better when it comes to this song. I'm not a great fan of Sam Smith, you know, I'm not going to go on about it, but long story short, you know, that's the favourite version of that song I've ever heard. And you made it sound so different, so unique. And if anything, you know, your controller falsetto, you know, it thrived even though you're ill. That was probably the most controlled, you know, vocally going from note to note that I've ever heard you. So top stuff to that. And to top it off, you've been so versatile this season, honestly. You've left a surprise each and every week, you know. One minute you're doing this song, next minute you're doing that song, you know, that's a very, very encouraging thing. And honestly, you should be so, so proud of your journey. I didn't expect you to, you know, your first audition, I didn't expect you to get to this point, but you blossomed in your second performance and it's just snowballed since then. But wow, amazing. Hold on. What did you think of Megan's performance?
Stunning, absolutely stunning. Your lower tones were so controlled, and this may sound weird, but I feel like it's better to sing a lower song when you're ill, because I know that when I'm ill or when I have a bad chest, I can hit lower notes. So that worked to your advantage there. And even though you are ill, you still powered through that, you still give that falsetto notes, you still went right up on your chest on that note. And honestly, there's nothing more anyone could ask of it. It was such a beautiful performance, your falsettos. And I don't think it'd be any different even if it was 100%, because that still is my favourite performance of that song so far. I loved it. Well done.
Megan, I mean, in all honesty, I mean, you could tell that your voice isn't 100%. I could tell right through that. You know, and when I heard you in the week, you absolutely had it perfected to a T. I don't know where the throat infections come from, because I wasn't aware of this until obviously you just come up and said it by you. I'm glad you powered through it, because that's what it's about. But if it's one thing you need to take on board, and it's the same with everyone, all the contestants, not just you, that this sort of performance, when you put in a position where you feel pressured and you're like, oh my God, I don't know if my voice is going to take a thing, just remember that this is only going to make you stronger and more, and make you learn and grow in this business. You can't doubt yourself and think, oh my God, thing. You just got to go for it. Because if this was a paid concert or something, and you weren't 100% well or anything, you know, you'd still get up there and still give it everything you can, you know? And that's what you've got to do, is that push and fight. What I will say is that I sent you the other week, because you've had some incredible performance so far today, and I remember saying to you about how much fight and how much passion and how much courage you were showing as an artist up on the stage. Obviously, because maybe you're not 100% tonight, I felt like you kind of lost that. You just been like, oh my God, I don't know what to do. Don't ever, ever doubt yourself. No matter how ill you are, you go up there and showcase your talent to the best you can get it. All right? Well done. Well done, Megan.